SciShow. Do you guys like SciShow? Any of you already watch it at all? I watched it before this particular episode and really enjoy watching it. And got to meet some of the people who make it, so that's why I got kind of excited about SciShow over the weekend. Got to meet a couple of the editors and a senior producer, and would actually really like to be able to have a partnership with them. We'll get this thing working more smoothly. I usually do the live videos differently from this, so it's much more smoothly running. And we can have Dr. Gwain join, and we can have, actually, the way it's set up here, some of you remember when I had Dr. Gwain on live with me, we can do that with you, the audience. Not tonight, though. I'm still working on it. Okay, Claire Bonnie God, you're there. Sarah Henneke's not having issues. Cheryl McNutt's, things are good. Okay, I just want to make sure that's the case for as many people as possible as I look down. And I do want you guys to continue with the comments. Okay, good. Lindsay Antwine, good. So if I can see you, everything's good. Elizabeth Audrey, everything's working for me. All right. So you guys go ahead, and if you have questions, those of you who saw the SciShow video, go ahead and make your comments or questions, and we'll go ahead and go over those. Just for a little summary for those who are jumping in now, it was about inhalant abuse, which would be like sniffing glue, spray paint, can't even include some other things that have unrelated chemicals like the laughing gas or the whipped cream. Anything that somebody smells or sniffs can be an inhalant and can be abused, some of them for horrible effects. We find that this is a younger, as was said in the SciShow video, a younger demographic. This is kids who are really experimenting, who want a cheap high. And so they'll try different things. And unfortunately, some of these very dangerous chemicals will provide a euphoria, a high that they can get from using them. And that's why they do it. And they'll experiment with different things. Once they've found one that kind of works, they'll see, hey, well, maybe something else will make me feel even better. Very, very dangerous chemicals. And I'll get into my own personal anecdote later on in this live YouTube. One of the things I'd like to announce to you guys as we're doing the live YouTube is that people who come after the fact and see me saying hi to all of you and having lots of dialogue, I'm going to keep doing that, but I'm going to try to put in a time signature in the description of the video so they can, people just coming in can jump ahead to where we really get to what's going, usually within a couple minutes. I think we're there. Does anybody know how far we are here? We're, I can't see how far we are into it. Nope. Can't see. I'll do it after the fact. I'll find out where this time was, and then we'll jump into it. Okay, there we go. Dr. Gwain, have you ever seen? Oh, he's playing dad right now, so maybe he's a little impaired. Have you ever seen a case of inhalant abuse in your career? Crazy cat lady from Tulsa. Buonanotte. I think that means good night. I'm not sure. And that's Marlise. Or Maria Luce, Elvis. Oh, BooBoo Kitty points out markers, sniffing markers, aerosols, laundry detergent, all stimulating. I don't quite like the way you made that sound so positive, BooBoo Kitty. Cheryl McNutt, laundry detergent. That's why I like to do the laundry. Not quite the direction I was hoping this discussion against inhalant abuse would go. Leave it to my regulars to take us in a different direction. So, I'll go ahead and jump right into my own personal, it wasn't really a clinical experience. It was when I was in high school. No, it wasn't me using it. So, Placer High School, that little alley right across from the cafeteria and administration building across Orange Street there, there was a student who was either in my class or a year behind me, I don't remember exactly, but very close to my age, who was abusing spray paint. He would somehow get the effect of it. Now, there's different ways they can do it. They can spray it in a bag or in a rag and sniff it. I've actually seen clinical pictures in my training of people who were dead or very sick in the emergency department with silver faces or gold faces. Why they like the silver or gold, I don't know. Maybe it gives a better effect for them. And it's from the paint. They'll actually spray it right in their nose or mouth to get the effect from it. Others will spray it in a rag. Either way, it gets all over them. So these people come into emergency departments unconscious, maybe not breathing, maybe dead. And they'll have gold or silver colored face. These aren't the people, you know, at Union Square acting like robots on a box for money. This, hopefully not. I guess they're at risk too. Actually, they are at risk if they're using regular spray paint for that. I don't know what they use. I hope they're using something that's a little less dangerous. They can develop the problem chronically or have acute intoxication. It can kill right away through suddenly stopping the heart or putting in a bad rhythm. It can cause respiratory arrest or slowing of the breathing to the point that they stop moving air. Chronic use, like people who work with the stuff, people who are using the glues for tile or for, it's in paper mills, I believe. Where else is it? Oh, painting, of course. People who do it over time and get it on their skin or are breathing it in, they'll have problems long-term, and it can cause serious neurologic deficits so bad you can even see them on MRI. That's how bad it can be. All right, let's get caught up with some, dust off. BooBoo Kitty knows the language. Yeah, dust off is a term for it. Huffing is a term for it. My husband does the laundry. He won't let me. Okay, liquid white out. Boy, you guys are really getting into it here. Natasha Lone, this must be a new feature from YouTube. You must be talking about the live here. Rachel Whitney from Birmingham. Modeling glue, yes, that's one. Talk about washing your mouth out with soap. Yeah, usually it's not the detergents. Gasoline also is something that people can get in trouble with. Usually it's from aspiration, though, because that stuff is just so slippery inside of the, when it gets into the throat, that it goes down the airway. You're not able to block it like you are water. It gets down there, causes lots of damage to the lining of the lungs. Some stiff gasoline. No, it wasn't just the 1990s. It was way before, and it's continuing way after. And those of you who are watching this after the fact, I'm reading the comments that are occurring during the live discussion, which is what these are. These are live discussions. If you want to watch them after the fact, you're welcome to. Also, live discussion. If you want to make sure your comment gets attention, use the super chat. You will absolutely get attention. I'd also like to know, for both the people involved right now live with us and those who are watching it later, if you enjoy these type of commenting on another video that's on YouTube or a topic that's in the news, please comment about if you like having that kind of news commentary, we'll say. Okay, back to my personal anecdote, this student who died. I was there, ambulance pulled up, and they were doing chest compressions on him when he got in the ambulance. So he obviously had already died from an acute poisoning from this Huffing. This was back in 85, 86, most likely, when that occurred. So it's been around for, it was probably around for years before that too, but it's still around. And we need to do what we can to educate youngsters to not experiment with that stuff. This is dangerous, dangerous stuff. It is not unusual for people to have serious mental consequences, permanent mental consequences, neurologic consequences after abusing this stuff, if not death. It's not associated with people with a high level of intelligence. After they've done it. All right, getting back to your comments. Oh, you guys are talking about more substances that people abuse, and something called Rush in the 1970s. And I don't know what Rush was, so I can't say that. I can say this is something different from the bath salts you've heard about, although it also can result in that aggressive, aggravated behavior, like the bath salts. Maybe some of you heard of that. It's not actually bath salts. They just named it that. But it was a drug that works similar to amphetamine that caused people to have this agitation and aggressive and violent behavior. Others, custom drugs or designer drugs, have had similar crazes and effects and caused horrible damage to the people who abuse them. And of course, for some reason, making these specific substances illegal follows behind their becoming popular as drugs of abuse. I guess that makes sense that it would follow after, because you don't anticipate what's going to be abused until it is. No law in Australia against it, liquid thinner as well. Elizabeth Audrey says, okay, I have a question. These are easily obtainable things. Obviously, it's not illegal to buy them. But if you do use them for high, is that illegal? Some products, yes, like the bath salts are made illegal. I do believe that using a substance for something other than its intended use, like the spray paint, I think there's something printed on it that actually says that. I could be wrong on that, but I do recall reading that on some substances that to use it in a manner not consistent with its intended use, that's the language they use, is against the law and very harmful. And in some places, they do have some regulation of these substances, but you can't totally regulate all these household items that people need on a regular basis for their work and for working on their house and their car. You know, this is stuff that people need to be able to access, and regulating it probably wouldn't even help if there was much more regulation than there already is, because again, it, you know, should we even bring up the hot button of guns? You know, people have them and they're not taking care of them. So any time that it's already in people's homes, that's where we need to take action. Although I actually am for gun regulations. I guess I'll just throw that out there and get a lot of haters for it. We'll not talk about that tonight. I know a lot of my favorite people will not like that also. His sibling says, a student nurse in the 70s cared for young people with lead poisoning from sniffing leaded gasoline. And they used BAL, which off the top of my head, I can't remember what that stands for, which is a, the word for that is, it binds things and pulls them through. And I can't come up with a word right now, the kind of therapy that is. Audrey Bunch is joining us. Hello, Audrey. BooBoo Kitty lets us know she can buy glue, but she has to fill out a form and get on the meth list and to buy sinus meds. So I see that BooBoo Kitty is getting her ingredients from a variety of sources. That sounds like a business plan, actually. You must have watched a lot of Breaking Bad. Paula Friend, spray paint is locked away in shops, but not, oh yeah, yes, it should be locked up for a number of reasons. One of them being because of the danger of combustion. And need more earwax videos. Elaine Swanson, yes, thank you, Elaine. So if you guys have any other comments, we'll go ahead and go over that. And also, please do put comments after the video comes out about doing videos to follow up on other hot topics, or specifically SciShow. If some of you are SciShow fans, please let us know. We'd like to know about that. Nicole Ann, thank you. Yeah, you're welcome. Mary Francis from South Carolina. Hope's all well at the end of the day. Yes, thank you. Why do people that make meth use sinus medicine? That's what they make it out of. They manufacture it from it. And no, I'm not telling people how to make meth, because it's a lot more complicated than knowing what the ingredients are. And no, you can't just watch Breaking Bad and find out either. So thank you all for joining me for this discussion of SciShow's show on the inhalant abuse and substances that have toluene. If you haven't seen it, go ahead and use the link in the description so you can see what we just talked about. Maybe you can come back and watch this. And we'll see you next time. Let me see if there's any last comments. And no, not really. So until next time, Dr. Mark Vaughan and Dr. Wayne Vaughn's out here somewhere playing dad, telling all of you to stay in good health.